happened briefly. Well, we basically lost our baby daughter back in May, like 2 days before my birthday. She was born sleeping. We went through all these quite horrible kind of complications. We struggled through it, kind of hoping for the best for like a good 2 months, which was just the longest, most horrible 2 months we could have ever had. And then we lost her like just after 24 weeks. It was really difficult because she's kind of officially classed as a person, so she's registered, and we had to have a funeral, and so she was a real person, you know, and she was a real little baby. And when you see just this little, what could have been a life, you really do start to think quite deeply about life in general and about how you're spending your time, and, you know, are you doing the things that make you as happy as you can be, and are you pushing yourself, are you basically wringing the most out of your days, you know, are you going to die basically achieving everything that you could have possibly achieved and to the best of your ability, you know what I mean? So yeah, we had like a good 3 months or so just, you know, I kind of took a real step back from work and just really, really thinking about my direction of stuff. And I was really loving the paper stuff, but I always knew that I'd stepped away from the painting for the wrong reasons, and it was because I was afraid of all kinds of things. So then I just thought, well, I can't really do that anymore. You know what I mean? I don't have any excuses. Like, I've been through 3 months of solid 24 hours a day fear, like the real definition of fear of losing this baby, of my girlfriend getting like seriously, seriously ill because of the situation. And when you're living like 24 hours a day for about 2 and a bit months, every single second of every day, worrying and scared shitless, that gives you a real perspective and a real grasp of what fear like really is. And once all that was over and you kind of step away from it and you're kind of thinking back on all kinds of things that you stopped doing because you were afraid, and you kind of go, you had no fucking idea what afraid was, what fear was. And now it's kind of, yeah, it's given such a good perspective on life in general. There's no need to be afraid of anything, really. Basically got all of a sudden very scared and like painting walls and just got a real attack of failing in the public eye, basically. I just felt kind of like so under pressure. And one of the main things for me was I went through this real rut of kind of, wasn't really happy with the work that I was producing. Started to get a lot of kind of self-doubt. I got very, very self-critical. And just as I was going through all that, I got asked to be part of that Gambia thing, which sounded like an amazing thing. So I went out to Gambia, and then basically I was completely unprepared. Everything that I painted there, I felt was possibly the worst stuff I've ever painted. And I was surrounded by all these amazing people, like Lucy McLachlan, Broken Crow, Logan Hicks, Zenz. And they were just rocking up and just like, and turn around, and they'd like done this amazing wall just out of their own head and stuff, yeah. Zens especially. And I was trying to like cobble these stencils together, and I wasn't ready. And I think that everything that I produced over that time I was there was really, really knocked my confidence back so much. I felt like the whole thing for me was such a massive failure that the second I got back, that was it. I just threw the towel in because it was such a big failure for me. That was it. After we lost Ruby back in May, I just had like about 3 months or so to like just a lot of time sitting around thinking. And it's got to that point now where I kind of realise that life's just kind of a little bit too short for not doing things through fear of failure. So I'm kind of trying to make a little bit of a comeback now in terms of painting walls and stenciling and spray painting and that kind of thing. So the wall that we're doing today is a kind of little tribute for Ruby. So it's the first wall I've done in 4 years. Big angel piece. So I've painted a couple of angels before, and they've always seemed to have gone down really well with people. Whenever I've painted them, you always get really nice emails from people, like the one in Dublin, the Dark Angels, yeah. But I had a really nice email from a lady once who just said, I live in Dublin, and I've got a young boy, and his dad left when he was very young, and, you know, I'm working two jobs, and, you know, money's really tight, and I kind of walk him to school past your angel piece every single day, and it's kind of like, and so me and my boy, we call it our angel, and she's looking after us every day, and she's kind of, you know, and I'd never really seen it as that. I just thought, I always saw it as a kind of, I'm just going to go out and paint a cool dark lady with wings, and, you know, and then you kind of get this feedback, and then you start to get a real grasp of what street art's actually really about, and the difference that it's making within that kind of community. You know, I wouldn't say I'm scared at the minute, kind of doing what I'm doing, because I know that I'm totally over that now, because it's just, I'm learning as I go, and I'm having fun when I'm doing it. And hopefully it's going to be the first wall that I'm going to do now in many, because I'm trying to get myself back into painting outside and being involved in the community and that kind of thing.